Thank you, Mr. President. So this is a very straightforward amendment that simply puts the legislature back involved in the process in an extended emergency, like the emergency we have been living through for almost 2 years, maybe at 2 years now. We're very close, 700 and some days. And it does this simply by saying for the emergency orders of the governor that up until this point have been not subject to legislative review. So the orders that prevent certain things, orders that establish mask mandates, orders that shut down certain types of activities, that these orders would be subject to approval by the four caucuses through their leaders after 90 days. So we completely understand that we are likely, we have in the past and we're likely in the future to have emergencies. You know, these are typically thought of as short term. It could be 2 week, 30 days, 60 days. This would allow us for up to 90 days. But after 90 days, like we've experienced in the last 2 years, there's a certain ability for the legislature to get back involved and deliver the type of government the people of the state of Washington expect. So it's a simple amendment that says, if the governor thinks it's correct to prohibit a certain type of activity beyond 90 days, the legislature has to say that's okay. And the reason this is different from the underlying bill is the underlying bill just says the legislature can weigh in if they choose, but they can do nothing, and it's okay. Which means the people of the state of Washington have no idea where their elected representatives stand on particular issues, and they deserve to understand where their elected representatives stand on issues and that they're engaged, that they aren't standing back. And frankly, that's what we've seen for 2 years now, Mr. President. The truth is, today, under current statute, the legislature could step in and change the governor's orders. They would do that in the form of a bill and a two-thirds vote that would override a veto if he chose to do that. We have the power to do that, but we haven't done that. We've just stood back and let it happen. We've been spectators for 2 years. This amendment says we aren't spectators. When we took that oath to represent our constituents, we committed to being involved, to voting, to saying this is how we stand, and let the people see how we stand, and then they can decide whether to rehire us or not. We can't just stand back. That's what this amendment does. It says we don't stand back. We're going to say continue, don't continue. And understand, Mr. President, this still requires three out of four. So it doesn't require everyone to agree. It simply requires a majority. Three out of four caucuses have to agree that we should extend this. And again, Mr. President, we've seen this can work on orders that are subject under current statute to legislative oversight. We've worked together. Many of them have been extended. Most of them have been extended, in fact. Where they weren't extended, we've seen oftentimes the governor come back with accommodations to address the legitimate concerns voiced by the legislature. This isn't exactly the legislative process as we would like to see it, but it's much, much better, Mr. President, than what we're getting today on these other orders, where there is no involvement by the legislature. This amendment would force involvement, would require involvement. We couldn't stand back and let it happen. I would encourage your support.